I want to show you how to make a twist and pop card. It's called twist and pop because when you open this inner kind of accordion folded piece pops out, and it's because of the twisting function of this mechanics inside it. I'm going back to Becky's place, and I really love her tutorials, and she does a lot of templates, but she is showing you how to do these by hand, how to cut them and score them. I am going to basically translate her template into a Cricut cutting file. So let's start with this first piece. It's 11 inches wide, 4 1/4 high. So I'm going to go into Design Space. And we'll start with the square and then unlock it so that we can adjust the measurements. And it was 11 and 4 1/4. I'm going to go back and double check. Short-term memory loss. There we go. Okay, so that is correct. And then the score line is right in the center. Okay, let's change that to white and go back to our shapes. Insert a score line. Make that the same height as our card. Grab them both and just say align to the center. And that's going to put that score line right in the center. Then we want to attach. That holds the placement of that score line. So now I can just grab the card and all of it moves together. All right, so that is the first base piece of the card. So now we have to do the little part that's going to open up and do the accordion. So that was another square. And unlock that. And I know it was 11 inches wide, but I forgot the height. So we are going to go back 3 3/4. So then we can go 3. Okay. Now we need 3 score lines. Do the same, change this to white just to be consistent. Shapes, score line. And we're going to need 3 of these, so let's just duplicate. I hate that the new duplicate moves your score line or wherever you duplicate way down there. Drives me nuts. Because at first I always go, where'd it go? And I think it's not there. All right, so now we can take all of these and say, well, we could do align center. And we know one of them is exactly where it needs to be. Oh, but that's going to be hard. I was going to do that and then move them, but that's going to be difficult to figure out the math. So we're going to do my little trick where I go align left. And now we're going to put the position at 3. So then we can say the first one needs to be at 2 3/4 from the side. So if right now the side's at 3, then that would be at 5 3/4. It's just math. So this one needs to be at 5 1/2 inches in. So 5 1/2 plus 3 is 8 1/2. Or we could have centered that one, but I'm just being consistent. 8 1/4 is the last one. Okay, so now those are all in the right place. We can go like this and say attach. Let's move this down here and let's do that again. What's the last one? 8 by 3. Okay, so there is going to be a score line going right through the center of the entire thing, horizontally and vertically. So let's insert some score lines. So this is 3 inches high, so we'll make this 3. And we want that one centered right in the middle. And now I'm going to attach that. Now we're going to rotate this 90 degrees and make it 8 inches. And now we'll say align and perfectly center that. It went behind it, so we'll say arrange backwards. There. Okay, attach that. So now we have to figure out this little cross X thing. So to me, it looks like those are on 45 degree angles. So if I take a score line and I'm just going to make it 4 inches in height, because if it goes off the edge of this piece, it's not going to be the end of the world. And I'm going to make it 45 degrees. Let's see. I mean, that's actually pretty good. So now if I make another one, that ended up down here. And I flip that horizontally, and now I take these two and center those on top of each other. Okay. So then if I take all of this and say center everything, that's looking pretty good. Okay, so now this is what I want to check. This said it was 2.5 inches in is where that should be hitting. So what I can do is insert a shape of a square and make it 2.5 inches. Because remember, I just guessed that that was a 45 degree angle. So if I do a 2.5 inch, look at that. That's lining up with that point. That tells me I was pretty darn accurate with that guess. Okay, so now we're gonna go attach all of that. So this piece will be underneath everything. It's the mechanics of what's gonna make things pop. Okay? This is our actual card piece. These are the inside pieces. Now, if we want to embellish these more, we can. So this is 4.25. Like say I want to make a top panel. This is how I like to do this so I don't have to think measurement-wise. I unlock this and make this, the height is 4.25. The only math I have to think about right here is the fact that this is 11, so half of this would be 5.5. Okay, so now this piece fits perfectly there. So what I'm gonna do is use my offset tool. And since I'm doing the offset to the inside, it's gonna make that little border a piece. So now I can get rid of this piece because really all I want is this piece to do a little decorative inset. But now let's look at these guys. These are 3.75 high. And how big? And 2.75 from here to here. So then the width would be 2.75. Okay, so this equals one panel. So if we want to do a little inset piece on each one of those, and if we want it to be the same amount of borders we did above, we can just do that. And now, see how easy that was to make those little frame pieces just because I already knew the measurements? And now I can duplicate that and put one in each one of these. And actually, I'm going to change the color of these because we wouldn't want that all black. Let's go with something kind of light. I'm going to go over here to color sync and just take everything that was black and say slide that into the same color. I can change the colors, and actually I usually do once I look at my paper and decide what I want to do. But I just want to show you how easy this is to do. So now I would have all those pieces that I have cut. If I want to add some embellishments on here, like a flower, or, you know, I haven't really decided what I'm going to do for the theming of this card. But this gives you the basic pieces, then embellish it however you want. I decided to go with a fun kind of jungle theme for my card. So what I'm doing first is folding the base card and then adding my double sticky tape with the tape runner so that I'm applying this really pretty floral jungly themed piece to the front. And then I have an accent color of an orange offset the cream colored text that says happy birthday. Here's another fun thing you can do. This is a product called Viva Decor, and it just squirts out these little dots of kind of a gel, and then you let it dry. So I'm just putting little dots in random places on this card. You could put some glue dots and then add sequins or beads or just something to add an extra little sparkle. You can also do this with like a glitter glue. Just put little dots of it to add some little sparkle and interest. I like doing dots of three. Now let's move on to the inside piece. This one has four sections, so I'm just folding on those score lines so it does that little accordion. And then I had cut some smaller pieces that were kind of an inset in kind of a mossy green color that I'm setting into there. I'm just doing this to add some more color interest, and then you'll see when I add the letters on top of this, they pop more because it's a light color and then the letters are a bright color. So I'm just going to place the letters in here first to kind of look at my spacing and how I want them placed. And then I'm going to use my Zig glue pen to just apply some glue right to the backs of the different letters and glue those in place. We have to make one minor adjustment here. Take this piece and fold the center up into a peak. I went back and looked at the tutorial I was following. It should point up and not down in the center. All right, so once you get that figured out, we're going to go on to the next piece, which is the mechanics of how all of this is going to work. I'm going to fold it on the center both ways, and then the middle part gets a little crazy. What I did was just fold on every score line. Then I had to figure out how does the mechanics of this all work, of making this pop. And so after I had all my fold lines done, I'm going to show you the little trick I figured out. This is the best way for me to describe this. When you fold this, you're going to make it look like a little house. So fold those sides together, and as you're doing those, pinch those closed, and that it points up like the roof of a house. That's the best way for me to describe what that looks like. Okay, so let's do it again. So make sure you've got everything creased and folded on every single one of those score lines. Get that started and bring it together and see how I'm kind of folding the side pieces in to each other and then flatten it all out. You might have to do it a couple times to really get it to work right. And now it's time to put this inside the card because when this is all closed and stuck in here, right, this is going to be what makes the magic happen. So, on one side of this little roof part of the house, I'm putting some tape with my tape runner, and then I'm going to apply some glue. I'm doing that to make sure I get a really good hold that's like all the way out to the edges. The tape helps it hold the whole piece in place while the glue is drying. So now I'm going to just line this point up so it's right on the center of that fold. Then I can put the glue and or the tape runner with the double sticky tape and the glue on the other side of this card. And then I'm going to just close it so that I know everything lines up perfectly. And I am just going to grab some stacks of cardstock that I have and set those on top of the whole thing just to kind of weight it down and just let the glue dry. Now that everything's dried, we can see how the mechanics work. The next step is to take the part that says wild and line that up in the center, and then we're going to glue that on. But there's a trick to gluing this on, and I'm going to zoom in so you can really see what's going on. So we're going to look at the center score line. And I know it's kind of hard to see, but on the cream color, there's the center score line. You want that to line up with the center fold of your part that's going to pop open. So make sure those line up, okay? That's a big important piece here. So with a pencil, I am just going to mark where that outer fold for the last section hits. So with my center lines all lined up, and now I'm off screen, okay, I'm going to take that last flap and just mark with a pencil very lightly where that hits on the mechanism piece. You will see why in the next step. So when I go to glue this, I'm going to flip this little piece back, and I only want to put my glue and adhesive on the top portion of this. So from the horizontal center line up, and then only from where I put that pencil line to the right. So it's kind of a rectangle that's half the height of this space. And of course my glue doesn't want to come out, but I'm just going to put some glue on here. Same reason as I did before with putting some tape and some glue. The glue is because I want things to be able to go out to the edge, but the tape is to hold this little flap in place while the glue is drying. So then I'm going to do the same thing on the other side, only on the left-hand side, I'm going to place my glue on the bottom. So on the right, it's on the top, the left, it's on the bottom. Okay? Why? Because we don't want the whole thing to be adhered down. If we were to glue the whole darn thing down, the mechanics and it flipping and twisting open just wouldn't work. So remember, you only want to really put the glue adhesive on half of this little notchy part. I'm just going to let this sit and dry. Once it's all done, fold these side pieces in so it kind of sandwiches together. Make sure that's kind of creasing right in there, and they all kind of twist. So then it folds like that. Okay. So you might have to do that a couple times to really get the mechanics loosened up. It pops open really great, but then sometimes it doesn't fold back shut all the way perfect. So you have, I would definitely work it a couple times to make sure you get the whole motion going. So I just grab the two outside panels and bring them together like I'm closing the book, and make sure those inside flaps fold on top of each other. And you can see inside how that looks, just to make sure you understand the mechanics. And then boom, it opens up. I'm going to do a couple other shots of it opening up from close and far away so you can really see this happen. Before you go, make sure to like, subscribe, and comment below. I love to hear from you.